Oh, I had to sneeze the moment I opened the stream. The green bar has been banished. Nay, shall it return to these lands? And nay, shall it's a heresy be looked again upon by the humble viewer until October. Is there a temporary banishment? Because, like, you know how the idea is, like, you know, I feel like banishment is definitely the most applicable during, like, medieval times, where you have wilderness surrounding a, like, kind of singular kingdom. But is there a thing where it's like, we banish you for an amount of time? Don't you dare come back here for, like, a couple months. And if you manage to live out there for that amount of time, then I guess it's fine. I guess it'll be chill. I hope you'll be chill. But anyway, welcome to stream. Hello, Riku. Maybe? That's what I think that's reasonable. You know? I mean, in Avatar, which is not a historical film, / series, freaking Zuko is banished until he kills the Avatar. So, theoretically, it is not a lifetime banishment. He'll come back home when he kills the Avatar. Well, okay, actually, you know, okay, spoilers for a decade-old show, but technically, shouldn't Zuko have not been allowed to come back to the Fire Nation? Think about it, because Oz, I believe he had killed the Avatar, and sure, that does, like, you know, like, mean they're free to do whatever for it for a time, but also, wouldn't it mean the Avatar would reincarnate, which is something they were trying to stop in the first place? Thus meaning, like, you know. And then he at the very end, he attacks the Earth Kingdom when he should be believing that the next Avatar would be a water Avatar. Which, again, it's just like, you're not really thinking this through, my guy. This is why Ozai lost the war. This is why the fucking Fire Nation lost, because they... They weren't always the smartest of peoples. I have the Hollow Knight. I'm sorry, I should have muted when I blew my nose. I have the Hollow Knight soundtrack on, and it's good. There are a lot of quiet tracks on, so I don't know. Maybe I should, like, make a Hollow Knight Bloodborne mix of the more enjoyable kind of high energy song for stream. We'll see. I need to make a lot of Spotify playlists for stream so that I don't have to worry about YouTube ads and YouTube kerfuffery. Also, more important than anything else, the boy. At the end of last stream, we got a bunny picture redeem. So here is said picture of Oswald. He was like, "Let me out." And I was like, "No, there's a larger animal around in the house right now. Letting you out would be I would love to let you roam free, but at the moment it's far less healthy for you to be outside of that pen. So if meat comes by, because I checked, Pneumatic Meat was the one who redeemed it, and if he comes by, then we shall bring it up again in order to show our dear Oswald. I love my money. Anyway, let's get to the thing. Because here's the thing, guys. I'm bad at making comics, and I tend to just fucking have to wait till the last minute to really finish up my ideas. Why am I like this? Why am I like this? I'm using this picture of a jungle in order as a base. As you can see, I mean, I added our dearest fossil boy here. It's kind of a simple, you know, comic update, but at the same time, there's gonna be stuff to it. I really like the art I've done for it so far. I just need to do a massive landscape in order to complete it. So that's what we're gonna do. I got impact lines too. Anyone care about impact lines? I do. I think I talked about this on stream, but I got, when I figured out how to do impact lines in CSP, I was like, oh, am I going to use them too much? And then I read some manga, and like, I forget who it was. I think it was One Piece. It was like one of the big ones. It was like One Piece or Dragon Ball or even Chainsaw Man. And I was like, oh, they use these in every other panel. Not page, panel. So, a bit of my anxiety went away there. You know, it's definitely not healthy to compare yourself to other artists, but sometimes it's okay to lift yourself up by seeing someone who's a big success and being like, hey, I can do that also. You know, I feel as though I am on par, at least on a technical level, with their skills. You know what I'm saying? But don't be cocky. Don't be mean. Don't be like, psh, I can do that. Why do they get the big bucks and I don't? That's how you become a salty Twitter user. I was going to talk about stuff, but, you know, Twitter stuff, but that's always about it. Isn't that just always a bad idea? It's so interesting. I mean, I know intrusive thoughts exist, so we can always kind of pin stuff on those, but you ever just be like, sometimes ideas just pop into your head. Not necessarily intrusive thoughts, just like an option to do something, and you're like, ah, that would be the wrong choice. You know what I'm saying? Like, ah, I have found the wrong option to do, and I won't do it, even though I thought of it for a brief minute. It's appropriate we're listening to the Green Path soundtrack now. Is that coming through okay? Should I put on a different playlist? Maybe so. Does anyone have a good, anyone in chat at the moment have a good, like, game soundtrack that you know is on Spotify and we can listen to? The problem is I need good game soundtracks that are, you know, not copyrighted, that don't get picked up by the algorithms, and, you know, in general are just okay, let's listen to long-ish, because I'm okay with stuff looping, but if it's looping every 20 minutes, then I have to be like, oh, well. Ooh. You know, I'm really glad. I feel like I said it before, privately to them, because you should always remember to show appreciation to people you love, but you know, I don't know what I would do without my friends. My friends weren't at the stream last night. I would have just been a mess. Ah! Bah! Ah, bah, bah! Hello, Shadow Mage. Shadow Mage, you're a cool guy. Face it, bro. I'm the cool guy. I hope you're having a good day, Shadow Mage. Shadow Mage, I hope you're ready to watch me squiggle for a while. Appreciate the sentiment, Cahill. Not the sentiment, the fact. The immutable fact of life. Brain Goblin's got hands today. Fuck up that goblin. That, like, Shadow Mage, go ask your mind goblin if it minds goblin these nuts. Because you're a cool guy. And it should have no room to speak. It's a brain goblin. I have heard... I remember hearing anecdotally... that apparently, like... giving bad thoughts a nickname in your head. Because I talk to things in my head. It's like a 3-man crew up there. 4, counting the asshole. And I heard that, like, giving negative thoughts names that you can, like, yell at is good. I named mine Doug. No offense to any Dougs out there. I'm sure you're great. But I know there's like some asshole Dylans out in the world, so you know, just happens. I've never even met a Doug, so it's nothing personal. But regardless, I don't know, maybe that'll help. No replacement for therapy for sure, but what is? Nothing really. You like? That guy's not great. Wow, I can't believe your brain. Shadow Mage, you take out that brain god. You remove that part of your skull right now. I'm gonna mess him up. I'm gonna show him who's boss. Thinks he can take me? He's a small piece of your flesh. He's a part of your frontal lobe. And I'll show him, the power of friendship and also this gun I found. Also, what was I thinking of? Shadow Mage, what do you think so far? Headcanon for my brain goblin. Because that's what I do. I'm stupid like this. Looks good. But all your art does, that's a lie. I could point. Shadow Mage, you didn't know me when I was 12. You can't say definitively that all my art was good. A lot of that was shit. But I appreciate it. I definitely don't want to copy him verbatim. Not the way I kind of do with, like, Hirohiko Araki and Jack Kirby. But I have been, talking about Berserk. As I've read it, been looking at a lot of Kentaro Miura's stuff. He's nuts. He will 12 then. Well, guess what, Shadow Mage? That wife and kid can learn to live without him. Because no one bullies my friends. I didn't learn that from Shanks after reading One Piece last year. I've always known that. Ride or die! And I'm always ready to die. I'm here to ride cock and die, and die hard, and I'm all out of cock. Thank you, Nuka Duka. Happy little trees. You think Bob Ross was fucking around when he made those happy little trees? Nah, this is real shit. Your art was good for time and experience you had. I mean, you're not wrong, Riku. But also consider. Fuck. I just want to make some trees. Yeah. I mean, Riku's right, you know. No one should ever be ashamed to practice. But ironically, and don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to be like, Shadow Mage, never compliment me again. But you know, like, a good artist will know there's always room to improve. So with that in mind, sometimes hearing their art, like, here's the wild thing, is that sometimes artists want to hear their art is good, and sometimes they want to hear what's wrong with it. And granted, that's not on their friends, families, and general just surrounding people to deal with. Like, you know, that's their own personal shiz. But I know, speaking from my own experience, I've often been like, I appreciate what you're trying to do here, but I know I can improve. I want to improve. How do I improve? You're not telling me how to improve. Oh, I want to improve. Oh, let me improve. Let me Peru. I don't know much about Peru. That's South America, right? Probably. I'm based on videos on the internet, I am better at geology? Geography. There we go. I am better at geography than most Americans, but you know, that's just kind of using things like context clues and when and also my GeoGuessr, my one GeoGuessr stream doesn't count. I know there was one time where I fucking passed a sign that said like the name of the town Uruguay or whatever, but that's besides the point. I know things about world. I'd like to get out and see the world more. That's the whole point of being a pirate. Yahar. It's definitely interesting to think about the specific way pirates have been romanticized. Because, I mean, like, kind of the idea in One Piece, at least, is just, like, anyone who doesn't work for the government and has a Jolly Roger is a pirate. And to a degree, I think that's accurate. So, missing some of the naughtier bits, for sure, but accurate. Hello, Juice. I love this butt. Oh, I'm glad. Juice, I was just like, should I change it? But you're great. So, thanks. Remember when Pig played this? I was lurking for most of that stream. But, like, Pig started fighting the Radiance. Like, he started streaming. He was like, okay, we're fighting the Radiance. And I was like, And in my head, I was like, Pig, have you considered what would happen if you were to beat this in the first 10 minutes? And then Pig proceeded to beat the final boss in the first 10 minutes. So with that in mind, fucking he did do Colosseum of Fools, which, again, from my position in lurking, I could hear not go well. But hey, listen, he had a good time with the game. At the end, isn't that all that matters? Well, talking about me behind my back? No. I'm talking about you in a different country. Totally different. Should this just all be black? Probably not, right? What was I thinking of? This was the Miura illustration I was looking at in order to kind of get an idea. It's not a jungle, but it is, you know, like a sprawled out field. Pig, check TikTok. Quickly, everyone, check TikTok. They've uploaded government secrets. They're neato. I don't remember this, like, fucking Kingdom Hearts ass gummy ship music in Hollow Knight, but you know what? I'm into it. Shadow Mage, do you believe I'm some kind of government agent? Because that's disturbing. The idea that I, of all people, could competently be a part of a major conspiracy should debunk the idea that there are any major conspiracies. You know? Like, I should become a pilot just to prove that the whole flat earth thing is bogus once and for all. Just to be like, hey guys, I couldn't competently like hide and organize stuff if my life depended on it. Uno proved that. So now that I'm a pilot, I can say for sure, flat Earth is not a thing that exists. Of where government secrets have already been this year. Ah! The Minecraft servers. Wasn't it a Minecraft Discord that some guy leaked government secrets in to prove that he worked for the government? And then... Well, this was a story. No, I'm not. No, this is real. Some guy who works for the government leaked government secrets in a Minecraft Discord server, and then all the news outlets were like, Discord, a service for gamers. No, this happened. So, that was in part what I was making fun of, to be frank. And like, haha. I mean, like, what's the difference at this point, right? Like, we're all just so jaded. I feel like it speaks to a level of delusion that there are people in the world still trying to take shit seriously, you know, like dictators and stuff. I said tater. Because, like, bro, everyone who's around right now is just handling so much at one time. Like, everything's just kind of so whatever. Like, why are you even doing this? Let's just, like, chill out. I am so tired thinking about modern day. The fact that anyone can oppress other people is astonishing. Like, cut that out. How do you even have the energy for that? Let alone the fact you shouldn't be doing it. You know? Does this make any sense? I just think a lot of goofy stuff has happened. So the fact people are still trying to be very serious about certain affairs is real goofy. It really guzz my yuck. Big mess of a rule.
Maybe they should have talked to a little man named Napoleon. maybe they should have.
What was it? I remember hearing a thing where, like, a line of different conquerors were comparing themselves to each other, and the last in the line was Alexander the Great comparing himself to Achilles. And all I can think of is, ah, so people started trying to take over the world because one dude couldn't help but compare himself to the guy in the gay historical fiction. I see. Interesting. Really makes you think, you know? Makes you think about the domino effect. See, that's the proper use of that domino meme. Gay Trojan fanfiction. Inspiring Napoleon to conquer Europe. Oh, we got a real comedian. But yeah, let's not talk too much about real world events, because, like, that's fine, chatmate. I'm just saying. There are definitely some people... That's the problem. And the bigger problem is that they make it other people's problems. And that sucks. But hey, I'm making a silly little comic about a little robot boy who can't read. So it's fine. One day, I'll work it into a punchline. That fossil boy can't read. It just won't be in this one. It'll be in there eventually. Eventually the world will know this robot can't read. But it won't be today. Have I said on stream and just around the fact that I nicknamed, like, I don't, saying Fossil Boy is a lot, but I love naming him that, so I just call him Fozzy, and that will be, and people will do that in the comic. I have every intention of in-universe people calling this little robot guy Fozzy. Exactly. Well, I was thinking about that, Shadow Mage, but I don't know. I didn't think it flowed with the comic. That was the original intention of the comic. I just, as I was drawing it, I was like, eh. I feel like that's, there's already a lot going on in here. A lot of information in these comics right now. I don't know if there's room at the moment to include the fact that this man, I've thought about that. I don't have my own wiki yet, but exactly, yeah. When we have, when the wiki is formed, after in 5 years, after there's 6 more of these comics. Let me try something. I wanna see, is this gonna end up making it look like, you know, like a valley? I'd love a valley. Here's the legend of the Kung Fu Panda. I watched the Kung Fu Panda TV show, because of course I did. Who here isn't watching the Kung Fu Panda TV show? Not the new one. The one that was like on in like the early 2010s on Nickelodeon. They're saying you don't want more Jack Black as Poe? You lie. You lie, good sirs, madams, and everyone else in between. You know how people will do the thing where it's like, X isn't a scale, it's a spectrum, or whatever. Like, there's that with mental illness, gender. I want someone to go, this isn't a scale, it's a dodecahedron. And I'm not going to explain that anymore. You figure it out. You know? Also, Pete, yeah, that definitely does. What would I call... I mean... If someone makes a Wikipedia of Fossil Boy... It should probably be called Father Time's Vault. Okay. So maybe this is going to be a spoiler. But who cares? It's by comic. I can spoil it. I can spoil it if I want to. So one of the major characters we will meet eventually is Father Time. He's a big supercomputer, and he looks like the fucking Small World clock tower. Where? Here it is. So this is, I'm literally going to draw him like, boop, boop. And then this is his nose in the center. And then he does like, and then he's got a smile. This is a very rough sketch of him. This is his smile. And like, the idea is he... Like, you know the golden disc on the Voyager? Like, his face is a giant, like, golden disc and everything. So, this is very roughly what he looks like. And he just kind of sits on top of a wall, rocking back and forth, overwatching Earth for all of eternity. So he knows everything. Bit too foundational. I would argue the fact that this is the first time I'm putting a clock tower character in one of my creations means it wasn't foundational enough. Anyway. But yeah, he knows everything. If it happened on Earth, he has a record of it. So. Father Time could read you your full name, your social security number, your date of birth, and what you did for, and if you went to Dave & Buster's for your birthday. He is near omniscient, and to a degree omnipotent, if you, like, approach him, but he's stuck on a wall, so... You know. How did you know that? Because everyone goes to Dave & Buster's once for their birthday. This is what I'm trying to do with fucking with Fossil Boy and everything. Because you know how they'll do like futures and like they'll forget history? So, like, someone will see, like, an iPhone and it'll just be like, an artifact from an ancient age. No, this is the opposite. In this very distant future, Earth is more of, like, a giant museum/monument to humanity's collective history. So, even though offhand most people won't know about, like, you know, modern-day technology and stuff, they can learn about it. One of the main casts is going to be somewhat of a historian. And with access to the records of all of humanity, she would be able to tell you, like, stuff about the 21st century. Probably not, like, detailed stuff, because that would be insanely hard to memorize at this point in time, but... What's that, Shadow Mage? I may not take it, but I would like to hear it. Shadow Mage, remember, there's no stupid suggestions, unless this one is. In which case, I'll tell you it's a stupid suggestion. What is the purpose of Father Time? Okay, so this is kind of spoilers, but we're literally going to cover it in, like, the next few weeks, so who cares? So what you're seeing right now is Earth. This is Earth... trillions of years in the future. It has survived the heat death of the universe and the death of the sun because at some point in the ancient past, humanity built a megastructure to surround it and basically turn it into a perfect terrarium. Father Time is the Chatter Mage, are you literally going to be like,
well, actually, that's not possible, because physics...
In which case, please Shadow Mage. Yes, fucking... Okay, why didn't you bring it up when I had a little robot boy? No! No, I'm not going to! For everyone at home, I adore Shadow Mage. And I'm giving him sass, much as he would give me sass. But no, I'm not going to! It's sci-fi! We were talking about Darth Vader and magic aliens the other night. Didn't hear anything about that. I was also talking about how this alien, how this robot boy can't read. Oh my lord.
Sure, Jan.
But anyway. I mean, I don't know what to call it. There's still energy and matter around. You know, Should I call it the near heat death? The end of time? Should I say everything has survived the end of time? That doesn't make sense. This is how I'm gonna advertise Fossil Boy to people by putting like scientific hiccups in you know, on a billboard. I'm gonna rent out a billboard and I will describe every scientific workaround I have thought of for the series. And people will start reading it just to be mad at me. It wouldn't be societal decay. The tepid boredom. I guess so. Okay, let me describe the situation for you, Shadow Mage. The state of the universe as it exists at this moment in time in the comic, the only thing left in the universe. Okay. Actually, let me backtrack. So, in this world, heat death was a semi-accurate depiction of the future of the universe. But now there are only three things left floating in the void. There are black holes, rogue planets, and, you know, mega structures that humanity built to survive life going out of the universe. That's a good drawing. So if you can describe that as a tepid boredom, then sure. Anyway, I like Fossil Boy. Also, I don't care about the terminology. There's lots of things I want to do with, like, world building and stuff, and think about, like, the science of the situations. The terminology for what state the universe has found itself in is not necessarily part of that. You know? I'm like, I don't know. Things aren't great. There's been more energy and life in the cosmos at times. Yeah, exactly. The idea is that Earth and the megastructure surrounding it are currently subsisting off of essentially perpetual energy machines. Generators that can operate at near infinity, or at least close enough to it that it doesn't, that no one was able to tell the difference, you know? If you're gonna be like, well, actually, they're big science generators. It's a closed system. Energy does not leave or exit. No. This is why Shadow Mage isn't subscribed to the Patreon. I'm not about to shame Shadow Mage for not reading the comic. If Shadow Mage does not like my brand of sci-fi, it is completely understandable. He likes my streams. So, like, yeah. But it's straining me. Uh-huh. I have to make a map. Shadow Mage, you're gonna hate what I did with the tectonic plates. You're gonna be real up. Damn. But you paused it. I did. Cause I missed the date. I'm not gonna charge y'all for missing a date. Shadow Mage is gonna hate what I did with fucking geography. I don't know. Maybe I should just explain things and let Shadow Mage get as mad as he wants to. What is the purpose of Father Time? Okay. So Earth currently exists as somewhat of a massive spaceship. A huge infrastructure, retaining the remnants of life, including the descendants of the humans who once built this infrastructure, who had decided not to leave and return to the other megastructure, the more modern colonized parts of space, to rejoin their brethren, and animals that have evolved over millions of years to now resemble different things, which are large frogs and chameleons, because I like large frogs and chameleons. Father Time is the AI. AI is kind of oversimplifying it. He is the near godlike mechanism, which controls both Earth's exterior and interior. Through countless systems, he is able to maintain temperature, weather, sustainability, energy, just fucking everything. As well as keep a complete record of all human history. In this distant future of Earth, Father Time is the massive, omnipotent overlooker of humanity's final memorial in a near-dead universe. I'm not going to do it out of spite now, but no, I'm joking. Go off. Go off, Queen! I mean, I'll be real, I'm always open to other people's ideas and criticisms. But I mean, typically I'll just spend days daydreaming about this stuff. So usually I have some stuff thought out, even if I end up needing to rewrite it entirely. But I mean, in that case, then maybe I do take the suggestion, because I'm just like, well, the thing I had before was shit. I mean, not at the moment, if I'm being honest, Shadow Mage. Absolutely. You could always DM it to me if you want to type it out there. But I am in private VC at the moment. I apologize. But I'd rather not move if it's okay with you. I appreciate your interest and offer, though. But it's up to you. Wow, how dare. But yeah, that's fine. Appreciate it. Appreciate the understanding. But yeah, I like Father Time. If he comes off, if when I finally draw him properly, as you know, a full character and a full concept, if people find him a little offsetting, then I've done my job correctly. Also, he manages how many people live on the planet. And if you're thinking, wow, that can't be like a cool thing. It's not cool. But he could be more ethical to people. Bye, leave our genes. Deterministic. Why did I add a stream marker? I didn't want to add a stream marker. Determinist. Cahill looks up a word. Ah.
Bye, Levi jeans.
No, the Levi jeans bot has found us. But, you know, modern kerfuffles have definitely made it so that I'm like, okay, Don't bring up any AI or whatever in this. Don't bring up the term AI. I've thought about that. I'm like, none of it's AI. Also, because we're well past the point in the future where we've had to debate if, you know, artificial intelligence are actually living beings on par with humanity. That's well and truly past us. I think I talked about that before, though. About the idea that we are past the point where we're debating if... Yeah. Probably. He is a supercomputer. He does do a bit of that guessing himself. I'm trying to think. Did I talk about the frog? I was thinking of stuff to say. Did I talk about the frog in my house? There's a frog in my house. The other day. Come out of the bathroom and he's just sitting on the floor. I might have told this story already. I hope not, but... Oh, you know what I definitely didn't say? If people are like, I need to hear that frog story, then they can say so. But, fucking... So there was this hamster at the pet store I work at, right? And this hamster had been with us for a bit. Like, you know, not like its lifetime, but longer than typical hamsters stay with us. And she was so round. Like, not to an unhealthy degree, but this was a rotund hamster. She was a chubby miss, and I adored her. So much so that I nicknamed her Orb. And, I mean, there have been people coming in looking for hamsters. And just based off the vibe, I don't necessarily steer them away from Orb, but I don't suggest her for them to buy. You know, I want her to have a good home. So I'm just like, maybe this hamster is good for you, whatever. But the other day, a very nice lady came in, and she wanted a friendly hamster, so I gave her Orb. Orb finally got adopted. And I will miss her, but it's good to know that she'll have a good home. And like this, I mean, part of what made me think about it was like, not just the fact that this lady wanted a friendly hamster, but like, she was just like, we got a big, big pen for it. Like a two-story hamster house. And I was just like, well, besides the fact that bigger hamsters are typically a little less, you know, timid around people. Because there are like dwarf hamsters and stuff like that. And they will just run away from you. Just avoid you altogether. It also just sounded like a very nice setup, so I was like, Orb, I think it might be your time. Yeah. I mean, I was gonna have stuff like that, Shadow Mage, but I figured it'd be better not to be like a 100% kind of thing. It might come into play. That he is definitely capable of knowing stuff before it happens. But I'll never tell. I'll never tell. I did ponder Orb greatly. I called her that because she would often be in an orb shape. Like she'd be all curled up and so chunky. That when I opened her pen, she like, being in kind of a resting or otherwise scrunched up position, she would look like a perfect sphere. So I was all like, your name will be Orb. And I loved her. We will miss Orb greatly. But it's better she has a good home where people will love her. That's the thing. I was like, lady, you got a pretty great vibe. You seem pretty chill. I think I found the perfect... And I told her, I was like, I will show you my favorite hamster. God promised to take good care of her, though. I love CSP. Pausing. When I'm trying to get work done. It's my favorite thing. It was in fact not his favorite thing. Drawing trees is so hard. You know how hard it is to draw the beauty of the beauty and majesty of Mother Nature? It's very hard. Mommy Nature has got some curves to her, okay? There's a lot of minor details you gotta catch, or else it will be an insufficient representation of the real thing. And we don't go for sufficient. Well, I've dug my own grave. I will never be able to recover from that. Oh my goodness, Laz! With six people! Hello! Thank you! Hiya, Laz! Hi, everyone! I hope you're in for some chill times, because I'm drawing a landscape for my comic. This is what we got so far. Hello, Val. How was your stream? I hope it was good. Let me give you a shout out. Oh, wait. I mean, I could do that one, or I could do the Twitch one. Listen. It's this one. Been playing Baldur's Gate 3. I've heard that's good. Haven't gotten it, though. Here's the thing, Laz. I was thinking about getting Baldur's Gate 3, then recognized I had no machine to play it on, and even more so than that, definitely none that could stream it. And that would kind of be my one. Like, don't get me wrong, there's lots of games that might be nice for me to not stream. But having no, like, big prior interest into playing Baldur's Gate, I was like, I could get it and stream it. You know, have a good time, maybe do some numbers. And I know what I said the other day about doing blind playthroughs, but D&D game, so. Correct me if I'm wrong, but it's more of like a decision-making thing than a, you have to be skilled at controlling the game kind of thing. Maybe what I should do is I should take my texture pen, increase the size by about that much, and nice ink works. Thanks, Johnny D. Star. Sing us a shanty. Well, in that case, I gotta. What was I thinking of? I gotta drown out the music a bit. Away with you, Hollow Knight. There's one I was thinking of the other day. A classic, if you will. From Tortuga's port, we set to sea and sailed for 16 days. In the biggest storm I'd ever seen, we'd almost lost our way. When a call came from a deckhand, boys, I think she's going down. But don't you fear, there's enough rum here to drink until we drown. What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? Early in the morning, way, hey, and up he rises, way, hey, and up he rises, way, hey, and up he rises, early in the morning. The deckhand took a barrel, broke the seal, and took a swig. Soon their panicked work turned into songs. Their work turned into jigs. The first mate bellowed orders, ever trying to save their skin. Any drunken wretch the captain catch, he'll beat all limb from limb. What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? Early in the morning, way, hey, and up he rises, way, hey, and up he rises, way, hey, and up he rises, early in the morning. The crew, they kept on drinking, all their duties long forgot. They were deaf to every order till they heard a pistol shot. The captain stood on forecastle, swung the cat above his head. Back to your post, or by my ghost, you'll wish that you were dead. Oh, what do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? Early in the morning. Way, hey, and up he rises. Way, hey, and up he rises. Way, hey, and up he rises. Early in the morning. Damn. See, Shadow Mage. This is why I said your suggestion was
no.
We're not gonna be. You're not gonna be that mean to Shadow Mage. Listen, if pirates could sing, they'd have more complicated tunes than sea shanties. If pirates could sing, they'd be singing Ariana Grande, okay? But they can't. So, we sing shanties instead. How's that looking? It's not looking too bad. Maybe I should do a full-on 10? You're pretty good, Shadow Mage. I'm messing with you. I hope you know I'm only messing with you. As a form of messing back. As a form of banter, if you will. As a form of witty banter. You see, Shadow Mage, you rob a bank and kill several civilians. And as I harmlessly catch you as the superhero, we make jokes about it. You know? Lord, there is something I want to talk about. You know what? Let's talk about it. Because I feel like it's more funny than anything. Freaking. So there was a fan-made Spider-Man film recently, right? It was in heavy anticipation. People were really excited about what this might turn out to be and what it might look like. Until it turned out the star of said film was racist. So glossing over that, the film came out despite that, which is a wild thing to think about, that you got that bad publicity. You know, I say that, but The Flash did in fact come out, so maybe I shouldn't be that surprised. Anyway, the film did come out in spite of that and people not liking the star anymore. Not the Spider-Verse movie. It was a different thing, but I'm not going to say its name because I don't want to give it publicity for several reasons, you know? One, I haven't seen it. Two, the thing I just said. And three, thing I can't think of. But anyway, I saw a clip of it. And like I said, I haven't seen the whole movie to judge if it's bad, but the clip I saw of it was Spider-Man killing two regular guys. So, you know, maybe it's okay. Film is bad. I love the part in every Spider-Man comic where he causes the grisly death of two regular individuals. Hello, Greg. You know. Yeah, that one. Again, I don't want to sit, like, I mean, I guess y'all can talk about it if you know what I'm talking about. Like, maybe everyone is just like, we know what it is, you can say it, but I don't care. I'm just not, like, into being like, yeah, this one. Here's the thing, don't hate watch stuff. It's a little bit of an exaggeration, but also a little bit not, to say that, like, hate watching just causes more bad things to be made. Not necessarily, like, holistically bad, but more so in the quality-wise. They made, like, 6 Sharknados, you know? Like, people watching stuff being like, haha, and, like, every now and then, bad things, you know, not great things are fine to watch, but when a deeper reason is given not to watch it, then it's like, don't. Especially in an age where people care as much about just getting something seen as they do about, like, actually making money from it. Like, views, yada, yada, yada. I love it. Lythero did a thing in one of his Dragon Ball FighterZ videos. Where they joke about a character making an apology video, and then another character just like not liking, not subscribing, not commenting, not feeding the algorithm, because that's what it does, online more so than anywhere else. I mean, obviously, interacting even in a negative format is just feeds the website to be like, ah, people like seeing this. Because it doesn't know the difference, guys.
You hear it.
Yeah. But hey, Shadow Mage, I would argue that shouldn't be a mainline Spider-Man story, just because Spider-Man not killing is so core to his character. And I mean, it's funny because I saw a video the other day talking about some, like, somewhat recent Miles comics where, like, a character, I believe it's Gwenpool. And if you don't know about Gwenpool, I've heard his comics is really good, so give it a shot. But, like, he talks about how crazy it is of an idea it is to think about just killing, you know? Like, Miles Morales being a superhero and just telling everyone, it's like, hey, are we talking about murder? That's an insane thing to talk about, you know? Like, it's that, because, and I thought about, so this is another thing I thought about, which is the general execution of superhero fiction, where sometimes it breaks more down into, like, just people fighting rather than actually quote-unquote saving the day. You know what I mean? Like, it's wild for it to devolve into, I think we should start murdering, you know? Like, that's not a normal thing. So with that in mind, like, I think the idea of a superhero who swears off killing, you know, accidentally causing it is something that could and maybe even should be explored in different comics, but whether it should be like a mainline part of their ongoing character is up for debate. I mean, people right now, I've talked lightly about how I keep hearing how bad the modern Spider-Man comics are, Peter Parker wise, and that's something we have to deal with. When Marvel decides the six, like, something shitty is going to be canon in the 616, like, Marvel is good at keeping ongoing stories, yada yada yada, so that just means we have to deal with that part in, like, our favorite characters for seemingly forever. No, Greg, that is that. So here's fun fact: Gwenpool is not Gwen Stacy as Deadpool. Gwenpool is a girl from a universe much like ours, named Gwen, who got sucked into the Marvel universe during one of their, you know, multiversal events. Like, just as a consequence of multiversal shenanigans, she got sucked into comic books, and now she is completely aware. And that's the main thing, because at first her only power was just knowing stuff about comics, but it kind of evolved into that she can physically manipulate realities via comic editing. Yeah, like I said, Gwenpool's neat. And like I don't get me wrong, I'm not saying this is a very critical thing, I'm saying this is an offhanded thing. I heard good things about her books, so that's nice. Captain N, not a comic book fan? No. I mean, they Captain N a fictional comic book fan. But this wasn't like a Make-A-Wish Foundation kind of thing. You know? Like, this was, I don't, as far as I know, Gwenpool is not based off a real person. An individual real person. She's based off the collective Marvel fandom. But not like a singular fan who knew a lot about comic trivia. No one won a comic trivia night and they're like, well, you're going to be our new superhero. Yeah. I mean, I think it's neat because I think about that a lot as a creator. It's like, in theory, anything I get the ability to create and publish, like, I can just do whatever I want with that, you know? It doesn't matter how strong I make a character. It doesn't matter how strong Goku is. Akira Toriyama can kill him whenever he feels like it. And people can cry. But as long as he doesn't give in to fan pressure, Goku will stay dead.
Yeah.
And like we were talking about, Schmage can say all the nerdy, dumb science stuff he wants to. But if I say the rules of physics work a certain way in my comic, then the rules of physics work a certain way in my comic. And there's not a damn thing Schmage can do to stop me. You know what? Fuck it. Flat Earth. We don't address it. Earth is just actually flat in the comic now. Earth was a flat, round disc, and they built a pizza box-esque megastructure around it to protect it from the harshness of the universe. I did talk with some people smarter than me. Because one of the things... Because, okay, so of the ideas I've had, one of the things I checked on is like, okay... So, like, the superstructure means that there's a roof on the upper part of Earth's atmosphere, you know? A couple hundred miles upward, you hit a solid steel roof. And, like, that's the part where people will be like, gravity would collapse it. Who gives a shit? But what I wanted to know was, okay, I have lights. We're going to assume humanity has found the technology to put lights on that part of the megastructure, and they are powerful enough to simulate the sun. Would daytime on Earth look at all different if a sun, if a giant sun lamp was hanging just outside of Earth's atmosphere? Yes. Yes, it would. Well, what I heard is that it would look, the sky would be a bit greener, but... I don't know. Schmage, let me get your... I mean, legitimately, actually, like, let me drop all sass and, like, all fake sass and stuff like this. This is something where I would legitimately like some insight. How would it look... Produce the love... Okay. Schmage... would be much different. Watch the angles, direction changes as you move. Oh, okay. That's fine. But Schmage, to draw the shadows accurately, I'd have to be a good artist. And that's not going to happen. So. I was more wondering about, like, color. You know? How would, like... Because we're assuming... The mechanism, this is the part where, like, the science nerds can, like, do whatever they need to do to justify it. Oh, fuck yeah, we went to the Hades soundtrack? I didn't even do that on purpose. Actually, let me make sure we go to the Hades soundtrack, because I do not want to, like, move on to something else by mistake. There we go. I mean, can they do that? Well, I mean, I would argue priority number one is making sure that the environment is livable before, you know? Like, we're already being like, this was a ridiculous... I mean, so I... This part of the comic is actually out already. Boop. Boop. To steal... I mean, okay, let me get to something else first. And then I'll talk about it. Because I say steel, but, like, it's just super material. You know what I mean? Like, it's not necessarily that. Oh, not that. This one. Okay. So this is part of the comic, right? The fossil boy lands on the outer side of... Earth's new shell, and after wandering around for a bit, he finds a hatch, like not a rock, a hatch that says "Do not open, Department of Human Preservation." That's gonna be part of the story. The Department of Human Preservation. That's the SCP League again. is like... That was a collection of humanity that was so advanced and so, like, just generally, you know, capable that they built a superstructure to keep Earth alive past the near death of the universe. Like, hey, Schmage, you know how you're Looney Tunes eye popping at all this stupid science stuff I'm saying? Imagine if there was an organization smart enough and resourceful enough to make it all happen. You know? And then imagine despite the fact that the world we now live in has extensive records about all of humanity, the only records of that organization existing is the occasional label on the side of a door or on an old piece of technology, you know? That's part of the story. So, but anyway, talking about what material stuff is made of, Fossil Boy, he's not made out of metal. I mean, like, maybe some of his insides are. It would have to be well-protected metal. Given that, also, this part of the Hades soundtrack just has no... Okay, it's very quiet. I would like to skip. But anyway. But, like, at the very least, his outer shell and the stuff insulating him from the rest of reality, that's not metal. Fossil Boy's outer shell, like the bone and the metal looking substance all over it, is a type of thing called atomic plating, and that might be a real scientific concept, who cares, but it is a type of material designed a long time ago by ancient advanced humanity that just takes matter and turns it into a ridiculously stable substance. No amount of energy introduced to this matter will, like, break it apart or heat it up. Like, he is nigh on an immovable object. It weighs a lot. Like, not as much as you probably think something like that would weigh, but it weighs a lot. Let me go back to raid. They're extremely bored. In tepid boredom. Wait, is something else happening? Greg? Thank you, Greg, for the sub! Oh, that means a lot. I saw this stuff about Father Time. Yeah, I saw stuff about Father Time. Oh, it is a raid. Thanks for the raid, Greg. Sub. I thought that's what it said. Well, I was looking at this little bar down here, and you just happened to be also who last subbed. Adverts. Welp. Anyway. But yeah. But Fossil Boy is just like, you can drop Fossil Boy into a star and he will not break. He'll be fine. And I'm sure that aggravates Schmage because he's like, no, nothing can survive the stars. And I'm like, fiction. I'm at least trying to justify it. Your angry Alex, your murderous intent Alex emote. I'm glad you like it, Schmage. But anyway, yeah. Thank you for the sub, Schmage. Means a lot. Helps, supports a lot. Whether or not I have a goal going, it does help. But yeah. For all intents and purposes, the ideas. I was saying I saw the stuff about Father Time, but nothing about, like, the idea of hyper durable, you know, hyper durable material, super atomic material. Is super atomic already a term in science? I know superpositioning is, but yeah, and how he has like a record of stuff and can predict the future. Yeah, I got that. But I didn't see anything about, like, the stuff he's made out of, which is what I was talking about with Fossil Boy. And the boy, yeah. I mean, I'd say heat death, but yeah, it would be accurate to more say near heat death. But I would argue, Schmage, I mean, maybe I'm misunderstanding heat death, but the only reason it's not complete heat death is just because humans have intervened with new advanced technologies. Adamantium, yeah. Just start, Johnny, just go ahead and start combining all the fucking BS metals from every other. Well, that's the thing, though. Like they've made it look like bone. Accelerate heat death. Well, are you talking about intervening with like trying to preserve stars, or intervening by, like, hunkering down? Yeah. I mean, also, to be fair, Shadow Mage, this is the stuff I left intentionally blank. Like, the trillion-year gap would accelerate it. Well, that's stupid. Shadow Mage, that's... I don't like that science. That's dumb science. I'm not gonna listen to it. But I mean, I kind of left that part blank. How humanity got all this, like, ridiculously advanced, deific-like, omnipotent technology and infrastructure, I don't care. Not important. You can make it. If it helps any science people at home like the story better, you can make it up for yourselves. Of MacGuffin metal? Sure. Oh yeah, that is perfect. I will 100% take that and credit you if you're cool with that, Shadow Mage. That's perfect. Because yes. And again, is this possible? Probably not. But the idea is it's not a metal. It's matter brought to such a stable state that no energy of any kind can shake it from there. Which means you have to be incredibly careful while making it. If you fuck up with that stuff, I mean, it's not impossible to undo, but it's expensive. And if you don't undo it, you're just left with a hunk of junk. An indestructible hunk of junk. Like, it is offensively impossible, or you're saying it's not. You mistyped and it's not offensively impossible. Because, granted. Not, okay, there you go. Because that's my understanding of science. Is you have something and using energy you change the form of the state of matter making up that stuff. Ostensibly destroying whatever it was. But say you have matter that is so comfortable, which is how you kind of phrase it. Heat and energy is atoms moving and getting excited. Yeah, that's what I meant. Well, destroying the item, changing the matter is kind of what I was trying to say. But say you get matter so comfortable, it's like, no, I don't want to move today. I don't want to get out of bed today. Then guess what? Those atoms ain't going fucking nowhere. They're comfortable. You can do all you want. Oh wow, Shadow Mage! It's almost like I thought out some of my sci-fi stuff. Like I said, I know the Earth superstructure is bullshit, but. There are other things where I was like, okay, theoretically, you achieve this by getting it like this. Do I know how to do it? No. Does anyone? Also, no. That's why we don't have it in reality. Is the least bullshit thing. Yeah. Well, so Shadow Mage, let me talk to you about something else in this sci-fi world. So this is how the superstructure looks, right? You have big circle. This is Earth's very hard outer shell, the thing both keeping it protected from stuff on the outside and conserving all the energy and life on the inside, and also not letting it succumb to the coldness of the universe. This is Earth. No. You're right. I thought Dyson spheres were specifically star stuff, though. And there's a bunch of pillars. I feel like I've done this on stream before, but who cares? Bunch of pillars. Now, for most purposes, the shell is almost kind of more orbiting Earth. Like, the pillars aren't key supporting it. These huge sections that are, you know, that are in between each pillar are not being supported by the pillars. The pillars are more anchoring it. They're both the method through which Father Time is able to connect to it and a means of making sure it doesn't fuck around and find out. Yeah, but Shadow Mage,
I need them for the story.
Not like someone's gonna attack them, but just as places to go. They are locations to go. Yeah, if you want them, fine. I do want them. I want my pillar, Shadow Mage. I'm gonna attack. Just. Greg, no, not the pillars! Also, that's where Father Time is. Father Time is at every single one of the pillars. He has a terminal. At each one. Which is. Okay, remember how I said he looks like It's a Small World? That's what it looks like. The servers and him look like It's a Small World at the base of the pillar. And if you're like, that sounds awful, it kind of is. That's the point. Funny. Yeah, exactly. Well, it's not just landmarks. It's also like, it is essentially infrastructure. Like, he has a terminal there. Like, so Father Time can just kind of have a presence in the world. Like, because Father Time does have a massive brain somewhere in the interior of Earth. No one knows where. I don't even know where yet, but the supercomputer containing most of his personality and information is located buried within somewhere in Earth. To make sure that he actually has a presence in the world, the pillars are methods for, like, storage, general maintenance. Father Time is very smart and is able to, you know, help maintain a system that is needed to, that is required to stay in perfect equilibrium if everything wants to live. So, a lot of maintenance going around most of the time. That is what a lot of the stuff is for. They could have just left it alone, but then it would probably fall apart in a couple million years. And that's not something they were about to let happen. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So actually, what you're seeing right now, like, Fossil Boy fell out of a door on the inner part of the shell. Yeah. Because you assume a lot, Shadow Mage. You assume that all of it's stupid, but some of it's good. I try. No, not that. You're still an idiot. Wait, no, I take it back. don't think you understand. Hey, Cahill, you solved one of the greatest mysteries of science. Like a monkey on a typewriter, Cahill. You've accidentally said something that our top men couldn't figure out for years. Is this transfer of energy? Yes? Yes. We'll after Shadow Mage, we'll call it anti-entropic plating. Ape. That works so well, actually. Because a lot of this is like, what's it called? Not paleontology. Archaeology. Anthropology. Ape. Don't understand the brilliance of your insane ramble. Exactly. No, Johnny. I know that part. That part I'm fully aware of, Johnny. Don't worry, you don't need to remind me. I'm fully aware I'm too stupid to know what I'm saying. Don't you worry. That part covered. Aesop. Yeah. I mean, Shadow Mage, you're right. I didn't think about this, but I was also going to be like, it's made of the same shit, just because it would be the only material strong enough to warrant making the structure out of, you know? Because you said it was a Dyson sphere, but when I've heard about Dyson spheres, I've heard they're generally, like, I've heard about lighter structures, because you need it to orbit the star or whatever without, you know, tearing itself apart or necessarily collapsing with gravity. So I was like, it's made of the same shit because it's nearly indestructible and thus wouldn't collapse under its own weight or by getting hit by something. I was also just like, some of the comics show you like Fossil Boy walking through the structure. And, like, the general idea is that shit is so complicated. Like, how they have made that is such a... Yeah. There you go. See? Shadow Mage, I don't know science, but I do know writing. And I've written. Let me cook now. Let me cook. I said, let me cook. Well, that was the idea anyway. Like, you know, everyone thinks of insulation and they think of AC, but I was like, it needs to be insulated from the exterior of space for both the purposes of energy and radiation, you know? And means things. I have dumb words and mean things. If you can solve how stupid I am, you might actually be able to understand what I'm trying to say. It absolutely astonishes me. You're acting. It's almost like I needed time to explain the concept, Shadow Mage. And you got mad as I started. Despite the fact I recognize the fact it would make science people mad. Would you guys say this looks like a forest? Like a jungle? Out in the world? Opinions on status of jungle. Let me add some more bushes. You gotta get some bush. That looks like a bun. Looks foresty, yes.
But not foresty enough. Shadow Mage didn't say I'm shitting my pants. It looks so much like a forest. I'm not good enough yet. I have to keep going.
I have to go even further beyond.
Anyway, Shadow Mage, I enjoy frustrating you. And I'm glad we get to have these chats.
I do not need to shit in the wood.
Yeah, we're overlooking the canopy of a vast jungle. Because, so, here's the other part about the general state of Earth at this time in history. Most of it is the rainforest. There's a lot of humidity introduced into the system. You know, it's very hot and humid in this enclosed space. So, not really caring about because the idea wasn't we need to keep current animals alive. The idea was we need to keep life alive. They brought it. I mean, to be, like, don't get, Earth is, like, you know, it's a bit of Swiss cheesy right now. Like, there's a lot of, they've mined a lot of materials, but also they brought external materials from other systems. Shadow Mage, because I want, oh yeah, Shadow Mage. I didn't tell you what I'm doing with the tectonic plates. So, they reformed Pangaea. Because I didn't care about trying to make a scientifically accurate map. I just decided at some point, eventually. Yeah, but I'm just going to draw it like Pangaea used to look, which I imagine is not what new Pangaea is going to look like. But I was just like, you know what, I don't care. Everything is Pangaea again. Wrong way, yeah, exactly. And I was like, I could try and do that. Or I could just, like, look at old theoretical maps of Pangaea and do that instead. And I did that. There's a point where it's just like, I'm going to be wrong no matter what, so let's go with the fun option. Lumeria? I don't know what Lumeria is. But yeah, so I mean, it's just, it is an incredibly biodiverse region. Most of the Earth now resembles a rainforest. The only truly Arctic parts of the world left is in a giant artificial biome meant to kind of emulate the Arctic climate for scientific purposes. But again, when they were building the superstructure, the idea wasn't we want to keep certain animals alive. They were like, we want to keep anything alive. So we're just going to build it and whatever happens to the animals happens. So, like at the center of where they all meet. Well, I mean, we already have. You can actually, if you want to DM me about the idea of a lake, please do, Shadow Mage, because I can run the map by you when I find. Because I have to make the map at some point. But I've just been twiddling my thumbs about it. But I was just gonna say that, I mean, there's already a massive ocean on covering half of the planet, which makes it easy to draw a map of the world. I only have to draw half the world. All of humanity lives on one supercontinent on one side of the planet, and the other side is just water. Or a Mediterranean Sea. Greece. Immediately. Shadow Mage is angry. But anyway, what was I just thinking of? But yeah, I'm excited. Fun world building. And also, now that we got all the science stuff out of the way, minus the energy source, which will probably also make Shadow Mage incredibly angry, is that, like, what was I thinking of? Like, after that's all done, after, like, the science whatevers is waved away, then you can just do world building, which is fun. middle of the land. Unlock knowledge. And Dead Sea means that the stuff in it is dead. We all learn something every day. The word manager. Yep. It's fun. It's fun to think of words. Hatching. I was watching a video about Berserk 2017, which is a very bad anime, and it was interesting, because I would love to see, it would be an incredibly laborious process and probably not look too great, but, you know, hatching, which is a very illustrative technique, adapted to animation, because that was in part the problem with Berserk 2016, is they were trying to emulate the art style like that, and it just looked bad. Because of the way they did the models and everything. You ever just work on models for about 2 years only for them to all turn out very bad? Berserk 2016 did. I haven't seen it, but I'm also not interested to. I mean, I'm reading Berserk. I'm not getting towards the end, but you know, I'm getting through it. And I mean, it's a masterwork as far as like an illustrative dark fiction goes. So with that in mind, you know, it would be great if Berserk got adapted, but not everything needs an adaptation all the time. So, some things are just very good the way they are. Sometimes you could just like make like a short film in order to get the vibes across and not worry about making an entire anime, you know? Oh, hey guys, you want to celebrate with something? I may have a much better part-time job lined up. That's neat, you know? Worry a little less about the needing to survive part of working at another job and actually be able to focus on stuff like stream and everything. So those are all the details I'm going to give, but better part-time job. Good cause for celebration. It takes a lot. I keep saying job hunting is a nightmare in this day and age, and it is. Lore, I had someone... What's a Job? Well, Job is a character from the Bible who got real messed up. What was I thinking of? And yeah, something happened the other day at my pet store job, which is a grandma and her granddaughter came in to ask about jobs, and like, I could see the entire history of what led to this moment lay out before me, and that the grandma, very like trying to help, insisted that she and her granddaughter go into the job together, only to be told by me and my manager, you have to apply online. You know, like every job that's ever come before, in the modern age, you do not apply via actually meeting people. You apply via fucking LinkedIn, which is shitty. So yeah, that was a thing. And I felt bad for the girl, because, like, I knew how she felt. And I was like, I'm sorry. I'm sorry you're going through this. I wish you all the luck. Because it's rough out. It be rough out here. Okay. So, honestly, what I think I want to do is I want to draw the mountain and, like, some sky shit. The sun, and then add the screen tones, and then I think it'll be good. It'll be good as I can make it right now. You know, sometimes you just have to try as hard as you can, and even if it's not maybe like completely up to snuff with what you want mentally, it's good just to get the practice in. Yeah. You say that, Shadow Mage, but even then, sometimes mom and shop pops have online pages they want you to apply through with like emails and shit. Yeah, exactly. Like, I'm Johnny now. Oh, sorry. I'm sorry, colors. Colors and shapes. Magical. Look, I made a mountain. I made a mountain out of a comic, guys. Just like what I said I would do. Remember at like the start of the announcement, the title of the stream? I was like, mountains out of comics, because it's like a play on mountain out of a molehill. You get it? Guys, you get it? I get it.
Johnny, no, I want to feel Johnny's skin.
You know what would probably just be easier? I was gonna go around and like select shit, but what I can do is I can just... So, here's what we'll do. We can make the tones we want for the different, like, the different layers of this. And then, we can erase them around, like, you know, the areas we want to. So, let's make this. First, I'm gonna make it, like, 10. Like, I want it to be very light toning. Okay. So then, make that a normal ass layer. And then we'll just go around erasing it where we don't want that. So, Shadow Mage, have you ever looked at a manga? I don't know. What is happening in my chat? I'm lost. I was trying to read and catch up, and I was like, I don't know what's happening. This song is okay, but I really like Lament of Theseus. Lament of Orpheus. Fuck Theseus! I didn't see that. You're good. Don't sweat it, Shadow Mage. Typos happen. I make lots of typos. Check it. They've just been in they've been out partying. I mean, so they've been giving me updates on the party life. Meanwhile, I'm here working my 9-to-5, trying to provide for our family. They just saddled me with this baby. Oh my goodness. You know, let me talk about this. Deja texted me the other day. It was like, I got you a present from my trip. And I was like, what is it? And they showed me a picture. And it was like, it's a plush of this guy. And it was Chopper from One Piece. And even if you don't like One Piece, go look up Chopper. Even better, go look up Chopper Defense Point. I guarantee you, you'll be very happy. It might be because of bots, but thank you for the raid, Shadow Mage. I love a harpsichord. This probably isn't a harpsichord, but I'm gonna pretend it is. Let me have my harpsichord in peace, damn it. Broke internet. Yeah. I mean, I'll joke with Deja when we see like stuffed animals, and I'll be like, our son. And they'll be like, our son? And I was like, our son. Look at this precious little being. We have to care for them. So I was trying to think, where is the song in Hades? And then I was like, oh, it's Charon. I love Charon. Tuesday is going to be the last time I do a Hades run for a while with no death defiances. So let's hope I actually get out of the fucking underworld. I'd like to. You know, if it's a consolation to anyone who's been watching those streams, I'd like to get out of the underworld. But it's hard. I'm probably going to keep going with, like, the shield and stuff. Because it was going well last time. Because, you know. Mess ups and luck. A combination of lack of skill and RNG leads to me not getting to the end of a run. But with any luck, next time we will have both ability and, you know, and luck on our side, and mayhaps we'll be able to accomplish it. Look, Cahill. What's up, Shadow Mage? I wait through stream delay. I love having conversations in chat. Be trapped in hell. I mean, the other world. Totally fair. Food's pretty good. I was gonna say a food thing where about what like Deja had taken a picture of. Like Deja had shown me some food stuff from the trip, but I think it would give away where they're going, and I don't wanna dox Deja. Like I know that's not doxing in the traditional sense. Not telling people where like where they live. But you know. Not everyone needs to know Deja's location at any point in time. If they want to come on here and talk about trips, then they're always welcome to. But that's them, not me. I'm scared about the political part, but you know what? I'll trust you, Shadow Mage. As long as it's not too bad, then I'm not gonna police ya too hard. Let's hear it. Also, there's no one here besides you and Johnny. So if Johnny's like, I'm cool, then Slightly. Yeah, slightly. Not something. Where was the only issue? Was this the good thing that happened? Or is this a different special election? Because I heard about the good thing that happened. Yeah. Oh, yeah. No. They're really pulling your guys' leg. Yeah. No, I heard about that. It's wild. It's wild, but honestly, it's uplifting. Because the idea that, like, Ohio is trying to do something good because people, like, want things to be better. You know, the majority of people living in Ohio want certain rights guaranteed to the people living there. And, you know, some people, for whatever reason they find, are like, no, we can't, not that. But people are, you know, democracy working is good. People getting out to vote and be like, hey, it sucks you have to do it again, apparently. that they can't listen to you the first time, but... And I mean, specifically the idea of a special election is they were trying to, like, subvert people wanting change and reform. And people were like, hey, no, we caught you.
Get that out of here.
So, good on Ohio. I don't say it often, but good on Ohio. You know. Yeah, when I heard about that, it just kind of made it also clear how much money they waste on stuff like that. So the more it fails, it's like, are you getting your money's worth? So, who knows? Maybe people who are very mean will just run out of money because they keep failing at stuff. Like a cartoon villain. And then everything will be much better when none of them have money. Best idea. I'm scared. I hope it's not explicitly illegal. But
I don't have the power to stop you.
It's an nasty,
a diabolical idea, if I do say so myself.
Carl. Make every decision done by the magic conch. We now decide what should go to the table via magic conch shell. Maybe someday. And when I say magic conch shell, I mean it is a... It does have a speaker in it connected to Tom Kenny. So we're just gonna trust Tom Kenny to start making decisions for us. I feel like that's okay. I feel like we can let the voice of SpongeBob run things, and that'll go well. He's worked a minimum wage job for a couple decades now. SpongeBob knows what's up. But this is far too the. I will say, this isn't bad, Chow Mage, but you've said a lot. You've said big words. But no, you got it. Honestly, activism helps things get better, so it's good. And also shooting down the idea of secret elections. Fucking... Who came up with that? Who said secret elections were cool? That's like some fucking evil Shadow Wizard Money Gang stuff right there. Voting in the cover of night to run the world. A wild idea. So, not getting rid of those would be neat. heart is in action.
I mean, I feel like it, I don't know if I've made it clear, but I think the idea of parties are dumb. Just in general. Not like celebration parties. I mean political parties. Just make up your own mind about, you know, what's good and what's not. Mob mentality never works out well. I read The Crucible in high school. I know what's up. Never trust mob mentality. Or else you accidentally get killed by Puritans in the 1600s. So, that... My stance on partisan politics is that The Crucible is a good book. Okay. I want to actually check something out. So... Ba-da-ba. Okay, let's do this. I'm just experimenting with how I should get this part of the comic done. You know? I don't mind some errors, because, you know, going for like a old school comic strip sort of vibe makes it so that you can make errors, and if anything, that kind of adds to the charm. I am kind of careful about how I phrase what aesthetic I'm going for now, because I do put these on Webtoon. I decided I should start doing that, like when issues become available to the public, put them on services like Webtoon. And I realized, I was talking about the format, and I was like, yeah, it's a little weird. And someone pointed out, it's like, oh, well, it's, you know, because Webtoon is from Korea. I forgot, you know, Webtoon was founded in Korea. And I'm like, oh, you're right, I didn't even think about that. It was pointed out to me how, like, you know, I should take that into consideration. Because when you put something online, it's like you're dealing with, like, a global market, honestly. So, you can't just be like, I'm going to do it this way because it's the best. Like, sometimes you have to consider. I do publish it sideways now on Webtoon. Just because I started doing it this way, and I just want to keep as much of the original flow of the comic intact as possible. So, in order to do that, I gotta, like, you know, trying to reorient it all vertical is just hard. I always just forget that, you know, because I always think of Webtoon's format as, like, a mobile. It's just made for phones. So. Also, if y'all don't mind, I see it's going down in chat. I'm glad it's just y'all two, and you're vibing about it, but still, I get nervous. But I mean, hopefully, Shadow Mage, everything's going well. I hope, if anything, you're more frustrated about the hoops you have to go through to get stuff right rather than just stuff not being right, because at the very least that means stuff is going down well. You know, does that make sense? Like, it shouldn't take this much being frustrated about how much hassle it takes to make things right as opposed to being frustrated everything is wrong. That's good. And hey, at the very least, I'm talking about nonsense I'm talking about nonsense, so if someone just listens to the audio of this, they're just hearing Webtoon ideas. Well, sorry about that, Shadow Mage. I hope things get better soon.
ignored it. That sucks. They shouldn't be allowed to do that.
I think we've come to an age where we look at a lot of things nowadays and say, you shouldn't be allowed to do that. Which I get. I mean, there's lots of minor stuff where I'm like, hey, that's weird and shouldn't be a thing. So the major stuff is even more so like that. I'm going to try and make it a little sillier. But the main thing is the Supreme Court. Because it's so wild. Like, granted, on paper, structurally, lots of good ideas with America. But then we have the 9 old wizards who live for eternity and judge our sins? Question mark? So wild. It was always a little funky, and then things started going sideways, and people were like, hey, we shouldn't let it be a thing anymore. And they got a point, so. Honestly, that looks pretty good. I like the idea of old wizard counselors are so much cooler in fiction than they are in reality. In reality, I hate the wizard council. It's not quite as dark as I was hoping it would look. Yeah, there we go. Okay. In that case, yeah. We're gonna fully be like, there we go. Hello? Oh my goodness! Kingfisher! Thank you for the raid! How are y'all doing? Halcyon? Thank you, Mr. Bird. Leading us to... Well, I'm a pirate, actually, so you have not... You're not at shore. You are at sea. I'm stuck in the fucking building again! I'm sorry to say. But I hope you had a good raid. Give me one second. What were you streaming? Was it a good time? I so hope so. I've just been here, chilling out, working on comics. So, you know, kind of doing my thing. Kind of doing the thing in my name. Everyone remember how that's something I do? Comics? Sick. Perfect. Everyone follow Kingfisher. Kingfisher's real neat. Honestly, I should... See, I'm going to be on... Pico's like, you're not at Max's streams. And I was like, I lurk. But I do not drop by enough of Kingfisher's streams. So I absolutely should. But they're a sweet bean. And super cool, so... Everyone check them out. Oh, I just got a text. Oh my goodness. Today's just been real funky. You know, today's just been funky. You know? You ever just have a day where it's not necessarily bad, but you're just like, oh my goodness. So much funk. Just a little too off. That was me today. Kind of makes sense, the way stream's been, but... I try to have a good time. Stream's still a highlight for me. When I get to hang out, work on stuff, do things with y'all. No exaggeration, a great time. As long as I can keep myself sane. Through broadcasting on the internet. Which sometimes I don't, but... Listen, we won't worry about it. Are you a shooting star? No. Well, I mean, I am trying to have a good time, but people are definitely stopping me now. The concept of life is stopping me now. Honestly, I just want a hobbit hole. I just want to live in a hobbit hole. I was talking about that again today. Because I don't know how many people in my family have told that, but... Lord, I would love to just at this point... Because, basically the idea that I came up with is just trying to recreate a place I went to as a kid. Like, I stayed at a lot as a kid, which was really nice to stay at. Because I think it would be somewhat, I would legitimately be somewhat kind of cheaper than trying to, what was I thinking of? Than buying a house, because most things are cheaper than buying a house. So... I was thinking about that, and honestly, I just want it. Life it just leans away to make me want to be a hermit in the woods. And I don't know if anyone else feels that way, but I do. So, TLDR, I'm working on becoming a hermit in the woods. I definitely want to see if I can keep streaming while being a hermit in the woods, but does woods have good internet? Well, that's the thing, because that's part... So, legitimately, Shadowmage, that is part of, like, what the idea is. Is, like... Because the expensive part would be getting, like, a site to set up on. And then, I imagine a lot of the money, besides just getting the main, like, you know, living space and everything, the rest of the money would mostly have to... go into setting it up to be livable. So, you know, plumbing, internet, water. I mean, water and plumbing, but electricity, that stuff. You know, basic care things. To get myself, just have a neighborhood commune. I don't know about that. Barry's chat has joked before about, you know, hashtag not a cult. But that's getting suspiciously close. So. Also, Shadow Mage, I do mean being a hermit in the woods. Like, we can hang out, but I'll come to you. You're right. You're not wrong, Shadow Mage, but also... I'm thinking about it as... people on internet tell me to go live in the woods with them. I'm sure this will end fine. Kids, if a stranger in the internet tells you to... live in the woods with them... don't... Just as a heads up. I know it's tempting, but... frankly... 9 out of 10 times... doesn't work out. I'm trying to get, like, you know... sun over the mountain vibes. Maybe I'm doing it wrong. Should it not be like... Should I instead be going for... Give me a second.
Maybe what I need to do is the opposite. Since I have these impact lines so clearly kind of marking out where the light would be, maybe I really just need to like... Maybe I have to like legitimately have it coming up over the mountains.
Oh wait, you know what? Why am I being dumb? I'm being dumb.
More than 10 feet. I'm a better man. Can't listen. I mean, if you want to, go ahead, but don't come crying back to me.
How much stuff do you? Zagreus, I know him. I forgot there's like a whole section where you lie to Orpheus as he writes a song about you. Though apparently, as I listen to this song, so apparently Zagreus in Greek mythology has been confused with like Dionysus, because that's the thing in some mythologies as they're trying to like basically translate the text talking about stuff. They're just like, this is either this character or another character, you know? And I had heard that apparently in Greek mythology, they have heard, like, Zagreus in the few cases he is mentioned could also have been good old Dionysus. Which is very interesting. Am I completely wrong about this, Shadow Mage? Are you about to... Are you really just laying into me today? Actually, let me see if I... Why not then? Okay. This is, to be fair, stuff I have heard secondhand, so I'm not surprised if it could be wrong. To shift over. Oh, okay. That's what you're saying. Kind of the opposite. Okay. Neat. I mean, it's interesting. I thought you were about to be like, you're so wrong, but you're saying, like, kinda. I gotcha. How do sun rays work? Maybe I should just... Okay, let me look up... Fucking... I need to look up just... different inspirational illustrations. Sometimes you need to look at other people's art to get an idea of how you should do something. And as long as you don't straight up copy it, then you're fine. Don't be a butthole. Don't straight up copy people, you know? Okay, maybe what I should do is take this, go like this, lower opacity. Nice. Okay. And now here's what we'll do. So, boop. Well, actually, maybe what I need to do is try and follow. Maybe that would help. I'm experimenting here, you know? I'm trying things out, seeing if they work. Does it not matter? I'm really just sometimes. Listen, I'm trying to be good at art. You know, that looks pretty good. Not too shabby. Like I said, it can be hard to actually capture some good-looking images and stuff like that. And like, the idea I'm trying to do is make this look spectacular. It's real hard. I mean, it's not really talked about. Hi, Paula. Hey, I'm experimenting here. We don't talk like that. I mean, legitimately, it's not really, because like you hear about like practicing fundamentals in art and shit like that, and you're just like, what does it matter? But fucking, they don't talk to you about the idea of like, It can be so hard to capture subtle shit that appears in nature and the world. So when you try and get that in art, it ends up being super hard. You're just like, this isn't some kind of big thing I can broadly draw and get the gist of. It is very much an exacting science. So, unfortunate, but it's what makes art so rewarding when you're able to so finely capture an image. Let me try. So, where's that sketch? Here's the sketch layer. How's that look without the sketch on? That looks okay. I dig it. I am into it. You know what else? You know what else I'd be into? If the fucking drawing look good. Brush side. Hardness. Yes. Particle size. Particle density. Spray deviation. Oh. I want to make clouds. Let's make clouds, chat. Cloud Mario. He's never coming back. It's so wild. Nintendo just brings in neat ideas, and then it's just like, and they're gone forever. That's just how they like to be, I guess. That doesn't look too half bad. Maybe undo this part and just lightly tap. No, very lightly tap. It's all Bob Ross. It's all kind of happy little accidents, as much as you like. What do you think, chat? Looking good? Looking good thus far? I hope it's looking somewhat presentable. I'm trying here. I'm really trying. Look pretty good. You're pretty good, Paula. So, ha. Huh. Everyone go support Paula's Ko-fi. Make sure they can get taken care of. They're great. Very helpful person. Have always been so kind. They deserve the best. In life and in also getting their tooth fixed. So, help them fix teeth. Oh, misty eye of the mountain below. Keep careful watch of my brother soul. And should the sky be filled with fire and smoke, keep careful watch over Durin's soul. Oh, whoa, whoa, oh. Who liked the Hobbit movies? I enjoyed them, but, I mean, that's because it was, like, my first introduction to Lord of the Rings, so. Yeah. I feel like that's part of it. Is people were just like, oh my goodness. It's gone so awry. And I was like, what do you mean? These seem pretty neat to me. And it's like, yeah, because it's any Lord of the Rings. You're enamored with it because it is like your first exposure to a great thing. I was just having a fun fantasy adventure. Which Hobbit movie? I mean, I'd say the first and second one. I do remember the third one being a mess, like even as I watched it in theaters. That one, even someone who had enjoyed the first two, I could not be like, I stopped for a minute and I was like, huh. Ah, okay. You know, I have been interested in that before, in those old animated Lord of the Rings movies. Just because, like, what? Because, I mean, the Lord of the Rings Peter Jackson trilogy, so acclaimed nowadays, but there was a time where that was the Lord of the Rings adaptations that people had. All they had going for them. Very interesting to think about. Keep working on this for a bit, and then I actually think we're somewhat nearing, like, you know, crazy as it may seem, we're actually nearing somewhat of a conclusion on this comic work. I've been trying to make it look good, and it's starting to look like something. You know? Starting to look like something that might resemble art. Maybe, possibly. I mean, this is where I'm not really comparing myself to, you know, like I'm looking at Kentaro Miura's work to kind of get an idea of what I should be doing in the illustrating as I'm illustrating it. But I'm not trying to directly compare myself to him, because he was a massive talent and very good at his craft, so I'm not gonna be like, I need it to be that good now, in order, just, I mean, that's just to help with my own sanity. I can recognize that I need to get closer to this amazing artist in order to really bring home the stories I want to tell, but then I'm also like, you know, I recognize I'm not there yet. Just one day. One day we'll find it, the mirror, the berserk connection. Which is a much weirder version of that Kermit the Frog song. You know what would probably help? Like, just some good old, like, crags on that cliff face. Like, mountains just get a lot of definition, because there's so many fucking, you know, uh, Just like crevices.
Crevices. Just in them. So it would probably help if I gave this mountain some. Actually, let's go back to this. It's not like 100, especially since I'm giving crags to this mountain. And this is a... Oh, first off, I want to draw... let me put in this massive black pillar. You know, like I... What? I'm on the wrong layer still. I should start doing bets in stream. Or fucking... If... Like, Will Cahill draw on the wrong layer of this stream? And you know, when I do, everyone wins a bunch of points. I will ruin my stream point economy, but... Such is the way. Such is the cost of being a moron when doing digital art. Is that it? Yeah, that was it. And everyone will be like, what is that? They'll be like, you'll never know. Until, oh my, whoa! Stop zooming in, please. I don't need that much definition. Hey, wait a minute. I thought I drew this thing straight. Like that? That better? Straight up and down, please. Yeah. I don't often miss Photoshop, except when I'm trying to draw like vertical or horizontal lines. Because CSP doesn't really do that. You don't get fully horizontal or vertical lines. You just get... You just have to kind of eyeball it. So... I do what I can with what I can. Okay. Not half bad. I'm gonna keep going though, because I would like to keep adding some stuff in there. Like for example, can we add like, you know, let's do some hatching. Or what I could do is turn, where is my default hatching? I could do like this. Nah, that doesn't look too good. Experimenting. That's the whole point of it. It helped check closer to that big money item. What, the insulting the first part of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure? Then maybe I shouldn't do it. No one here needs to insult Phantom Blood. You don't understand. If you want to insult Phantom Blood, you don't understand Phantom Blood. Oh, wait. Stop. Why does this happen? Phantom Blood serves its purpose faithfully. It should not be berated for doing so.
Everyone loves to be like, oh, it's, I don't like it. Well, guess what? You're not supposed to like it. Eat your vegetables.
I'll eat your cake, peas and carrots. Oh.
Not everything is Goku fighting Frieza. Sometimes you have to watch a British aristocrat kill his vampire brother before you get to stopping time with ghosts. You know? It's just the way of the world. You shouldn't be mean to the British aristocrat for that. You can be mean to British aristocrats for lots of things, just not that specific thing. And that specific British aristocrat. You know what might actually be good? Like, legitimately? I'm just gonna, like, get rid of the impact lines I have currently. That does take... I mean, I do... The impact lines definitely add something, so... They are there for a reason, for sure. I'm glad to report. But I think I should do better impact lines. Think that would be much nicer. Okay. Boop. And then impact lines. Center it on the boy. I should erase where it's affecting the mist, because... Oh, let me get that one. Select here. No. Man, I'm... This is why... This is why I staved off doing digital art so long, because I just get so messed up with the tools. I have clumsy fingers, okay? I think that looks good. Yeah, look at that. That looks... Honestly, I think that looks great. Personally, I think it looks pretty good. Let me add one more thing. Oh, wait a minute. Honestly, let's just solidify this, merge all these layers into the art layer. And then I also want to do this. His theoretically, his head should not be shiny, but I'm gonna make it a little shiny, you know, just a little bit of shine. Or maybe what we do instead is that, make this a bit smaller. Honestly, I'm, you know, like, no Mona Lisa, but I'm pretty proud of this one. Looks pretty good, IMO. So I hope people will enjoy it when I put all the text over it, add a bit of stuff off screen to it, and make it look all nice and fancy. But I appreciate people for joining me and trying to make it look so nice. Means a lot, guys. Like, I could do that sitting at home by myself, or I can hang out with some people and actually, you know, have some fun while doing it. Let's see who's streaming. I'm looking at different people. I'm gonna raid Nicole. Nicole's neat. They're streaming Subnautica. And that's the only those are the only reasons I need. So I appreciate everyone coming. And I will see you tomorrow for some actual like animation work and everything. So thanks for coming, guys. Bye.